Hi everyone, Divya Pandit here. Here we start with our next zodiac sign, that is Taurus. Taurus, October 2024. Okay, Taurians are going through a lot of inner conflict. I think there is a lot of verbal attacks being happening to them. Is that so? Let me know in the comments if this is true. Okay, a lot of verbal attacks, a lot of not good state of mind, that kind of a situation. And before I go further in the reading, please press the bell icon, subscribe to my channel and share it with your family and friends. I feel Taurians, you are going through a conflicting time. There was a time where you used to, your aims were very short term. Now I feel your aims are not short term. You want to go long term. You're thinking of long term plans in your life. Anyways, this is a year of Shani. Shani will make you think long term. Shani doesn't like short term plans. Alright, let's see. You are right now feeling like, I feel there is a very urge of to party and be happy and be there. That's what is coming in the near future. You're going to meet more people, connect with more people, party with more people. Right now you have gone into your shell, but slowly, slowly I feel you're coming out. There are a lot of offers at work coming. So yes, work is coming. Okay, work is coming for sure. So the first week of October is going to bring you reconciliation with maybe old friends you had disconnected from a long time. You will meet them back, or you will meet someone from your past, or your brother, sisters will all come together, cousins who you've not met since a long time, or you will meet somebody whom you had worked with in the past, you will come together with that person. Okay, the first week is all about emotional happiness, feeling good. And people who are looking for reconciliation, first week of October is very good time. Second week is all about a very deadly time where you will actually, deadly is not, I'm not trying to scare you, but a time where you will actually feel very toxic. Now it depends, people who are into business, which the money is coming under the table, or business which is not ethical, they are going to benefit. Yes, although it's a year of Shani, but that's the way of Shani actually taking your exams. Remember, whether you're going to pass or no, whether you're going to take that money or no. But yes, at this time, money will come under the table. Okay, and for the other people who don't know all this, there is a time where you have to take care of your health. The environment around you is going to be very toxic. I feel people who were nice to you, especially females, will start attacking you. And I actually see a female who is elderly. Probably she'll be a mother figure, or somebody who has a boss who is a female. Or it could be somebody who, it could be a wife, it could be anyone, but little elderly in age. And will be in a very attacking mode. Okay, this person is going to try to, I know I'm getting a lot of emotional blackmail. Okay, this person has a lot of money, is very abundant, this lady, and she's very well versed with spirituality, and probably she also has a guru. I don't know whom it might resonate to, but this person takes a lot of guidance from people like me or some kind of a guru. Will manipulate you and create such a situation around you that you will feel very trapped and very toxic. This might even affect your health. Okay, at such a time, to have more clarity in life, one should always keep a clear cause with them, or wear a mala, that is a crystal clear mala, that will help you. Okay, do a lot of protection at this time. Protection could be Hanuman Chalisa, protection could be, aura cleansing constantly, so that we do not get trapped in such a situation. We have clarity over it. Okay. Third week is all about overcoming all your obstacles. It's a good week where whatever problems that will come to you, you will be able to overcome it. And wherever you want to go in life, you will be able to go. Fourth week is about coming back in your power. Coming out of all the toxicity, coming back in your power, and probably this time you will also gain a money position, and you are going to be a little generous also to people around you. Okay, but at the same time, be careful about your money. Being generous could also be giving donation to an organization or to somebody poor, so that, you know, it creates a good energy, right? So that could happen. So please take care, Taurus, especially in the second week of October. Do all the as many remedies as you can. There's a lot on my channel, okay, on my shorts also, and Instagram, Facebook reels also. Facebook is all mostly Hindi content. So yes, go there and see. Let's see what we have in your relationship. Okay, let's see. I feel that your chakras are majorly blocked, Taurus. Especially your sacral chakra, and you're not ready to acknowledge what is actually going wrong in your life. Sacral chakra is blocked. You're not ready to see, or you're not ready to acknowledge what people are actually telling you. People who are married will have a good relationship. They will be very happy. Everything will be very, very nice for them. Relationship will go well. Things are changing in a bit, you know, for better in life. And people who are single, okay, they need to really change their perspective. And also, I feel their third eye is majorly blocked. So they might be a little depressed or not looking into the right direction. Okay. Here they want to succeed, but at the same time, they don't want to look at the positive side of life. What universe is actually giving them. More doors are opening for you, Taurus. Okay. In the month of August for relationship. So I don't think it's going to be bad. It's going to be good for especially single people. Especially married people. Single people really need to change their perspective so that they can invite somebody good in their life. Communication is a key. Use a lot of blue colors around you. Wear blue color in the month of October. Wear a lot of blues that will help you. Okay, let's see what we have for you as a message from Ganesh. Harmony. Wow, be in harmony. And it's a sacred chakra. Basically, see how Ganesh is holding the chakra here. And a lot of orange color here. So creativity is the key. Orange color is about creativity. So Ganesh is asking you to create. Create something for yourself. Create harmony for yourself. Create abundance for yourself. Create money for yourself. Create good relationships for yourself. And in all that journey, Ganesh is with you. Everything is coming. Just have patience. Okay. That's all for today. Please follow me on Instagram, Facebook. And don't forget to subscribe and email me and message me for paid appointments. That's all for today. Goodbye. God bless. Take care. Bye.